Hello, you're watching Proactive. I'm joined by Anthony Hamilton. He's the CEO of Georgina Energy. Tony, you're out with an operational update with details of your work progress, or your work programs rather, and that follows your admission to the main market of the LSE right at the end of July. So you really have hit the ground running.
Yeah, thanks, Stephen. It's we listed on the 30th, and here we are 8-9 days later with an operational update. I literally stepped off the plane on Monday night. Tuesday, I was in the office with our operational guys, and Wednesday, I went through everything, and Thursday, the operational update was released. So we've been running for some time now.
So take us through what this operational update entails, because it's all about the developments of the Hussar-1 well that's in Western Australia.
Well, essentially, everything we say in that in the operational update is to do with commencing drilling operations at Hussar in December. So keynote to that is we've commissioned a scoping study. The purpose of that essentially is to provide estimates and sensitivity analysis for the capital and operating costs for the gas separation, which will be operated by the off-taker. And the primary reason for doing that is because we want to fully understand when we come to negotiating the terms of the contract. Because again, as I've said previously, we are selling the gas at the wellhead, which sort of then leads into the next part, which is the MOU. And obviously, we are executing an extension to that. But reflective of that is the fact that one of the key elements is we want to be reimbursed for our costs to develop Hussar. And so therefore, if the off-taker or off-takers wish to ultimately have us sign a contract, then clearly we want to be reimbursed for whatever we've spent to develop both Hussar and ultimately Mount Winter. In terms of the drilling permits, there is a fairly specific process, as I think I previously told people. We already had our environmental impact study done when we got the permit, and we also had our land access agreements with the native title Indigenous parties. So what we're now doing is we're getting clearance from the Land Council under our native title agreement. We're also updating our environmental impact study, and then we're completing all our drilling plans, which will go to DEMIRS, which is the regulatory body here in Australia, who will grant us the permit for drilling. And that includes everything from the rig to the operator to safety plans, how we're going to re-enter the well, a whole range of different elements which we have to disclose so that the permit can be granted. The next one is probably the most interesting, and that is the resource evaluation. And primarily, when we started the development at Hussar, we were using seismic information, which is 40 years old. We had shot AMPTP surveys over the whole area. We processed some of the data to a point, and obviously after that, we stopped primarily because we didn't want to compromise our CPR. However, on my return to Australia, our technical team advised that they've been able to secure additional reprocessed seismic data. That, along with additionally tying that in with synthesizing the AEMPTP data, will provide us with a couple of elements. One, it'll allow us to understand or quantify the scale and size of the resource, but also more importantly, it will identify any additional structures because, as I said originally in my presentation, the original AEMPTP showed an enormous gas anomaly. So obviously, from our perspective, it's very important that we get a really big and clear understanding of the scale and size of Hussar. Then, of course, there's all that tied together, ties up with the re-entry logistics, which we have perfect re-entry access with roads and everything else, but while I was away, the council kindly commissioned grading and extending the runway at the airstrip, which is adjacent to Hussar. And so that now means that we can land quite a large aircraft there for influx of equipment, personnel, and anything else that we need.
Tony, in the meantime, can you give us an update on what's happening at Mount Winter?
At Mount Winter, we our Indigenous consultant, Bob Liddell, he's advised us that we should anticipate receiving a formal request for an on-ground meeting with the Indigenous land and traditional landowners, which is the key element to obtaining the conversion to a full EP. And you must get that agreement first. And then once you've got that, then ultimately the permit will be granted by the government. So we're hoping to receive a formal written notification anytime soon. Of course, the moment we do, both ourselves and Mosman will obviously make an announcement. And then we pretty much will hit the ground running. We will be required straight away to do seismic work, reprocessing, plus a whole range of other things. And the benefit of Mount Winter is that everything that we're doing at Hussar will be able to replicate at Mount Winter. So it's going to be an extremely busy time for us.
Well, it sounds like it, Tony. I hope you'll keep us updated on any progress, but thank you very much for speaking with us today.
Thank you, Stephen. My pleasure.
That's Anthony Hamilton, the CEO of Georgina Energy.